Mayor. Congratulate my honourable friend for securing it. I thought he did a brilliant job in his opening speech of explaining why the dashboard is so welcome and so necessary, and I won't take up too much time going over old ground. I just really wanted to, again, really remark on why the dashboard is so important and so necessary, because whilst it is absolutely the case that we have 9 million new people coming into the workplace pensions scheme through auto-enrolment, and these people will hopefully be more engaged in their pension savings and continue to be throughout their working life. Historically, that is simply not the case. There are many people who, quite frankly, have absolutely no idea what sort of pension savings they have built up over 20, 30, 40 years of work. Many companies that they might have used to work for no longer exist. Insurance companies which used to hold their pension schemes may have been merged, amalgamated, and no longer exist at all. And then suddenly you find yourself coming up to reach retirement and not really having any idea, other than perhaps your one main employer that you were with a long time, what sort of pension savings you might have. And so it's not particularly surprising that there was research that said that one in five adults will admit to having lost at least one pension pot. But I think that probably understates it, because there'll be people who firstly don't admit that they can't remember what pension savings they have, and secondly there'll be people who don't know that they don't know what pension savings that they had. And so I think that the research from the Pensions Policy Institute, which suggested there was about £19.5 billion worth in pots that consumers have lost track of, really does reinforce why we need this dashboard, why it needs to be all-encompassing, and as another member said, why we do need to make sure that all the providers are properly committed to signing up to providing the information, because it's not going to be much use if the dashboard is only any good to you depending on which provider you were linked with in the workplace, because otherwise what's the point? This needs to be something that works for absolutely everybody. I wasn't too bothered when the government decided to take a slightly different approach and push more onto lead onto the private sector. I thought that was perfectly sensible. The private sector had been doing most of the running in terms of its development anyway, but I do think it is vital that whatever the final component of the dashboard or various dashboards look like, that the state pension element is included within it to give people that full picture of their retirement saving. And I did like the idea that was made by my honourable friend from Soil, who's no longer in his place, of looking at ways to link this up with broader financial products. But we should probably walk before we can run and make sure that we get the dashboard up and running before we start making it more complicated. I just had a couple of questions for the Minister. First, the honourable gentleman from Strangford raised issues about data security and identity risk. I think they're very real. I mean, there's lots of good stuff being done through Government Gateway to protect that, but I think we will need to be pretty satisfied through the regulatory framework that data is secure and there isn't going to be dangers with people getting... yes, of course.
It may help the House if I address the point that raised by the honourable gentleman, raised by my honourable friend who opened the debate, and also my honourable friend for East Renfrewshire. If I make the point that in the consultation at page 29... and chapter 4 of the consultation, if you haven't had an opportunity to see it, it is set out in quite a lot of detail the efforts that we propose to take in relation to data security. Clearly, this is subject to the consultation, but without any shadow of a doubt, there is not a proposal that this is going to be a data storage device and that this is individual provision of one individual's data from the pension company back to the individual, rather than going to a conglomerated site that is eminently more hackable for obvious reasons.
I thank the Minister for that intervention. I think that clarifies the point very nicely and very usefully. The other question I just had was around the industry delivery group. I don't know whether the Minister is in any kind of position to explain the process for setting that up, when it's likely to be set up. And I think the main point is just making sure that's got the right mix of experience and background on it to deliver. And I'll just close by saying I think the pensions dashboard is another very good example of good pensions policy being built up on a consensual cross-party basis, because as auto-enrolment, as more people are coming into the pension system, being able to keep track of what you've saved over your long-term working life is going to be absolutely critical.
Thanks, Mick.